Thank you. Happy birthday, Lady Orr, and many, many more.
Lady Orr, may God bless you and bring more happiness to your life.
Happy birthday, Lady Orr.
Happy birthday to ya. Happy birthday to ya. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday,
Mrs. Orr.
We love you.
We love you.
Thank you so much for everything you do for not only my family, but so many Brown Baptist families. We're praying that you have many, many, many more blessings.
You're so great and so fabulous that we love you so much.
Thank you.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Aunt Valerie. Woo! I hope this is a great one for you. I cannot wait to celebrate your birthday with you on today. Love you.
Happy birthday, First Lady Orr. We want you to know that we love you and we wish you many, many more. I remember when I first came to Brown, it was just Pastor Orr and you, and now the family has really grown and God is truly blessing and you look marvelous. So happy birthday. God bless you and I'm out.
Happy birthday, First Lady Valerie Orr. We thank you so much for all you do for us here at Brown Baptist.
Happy birthday, First Lady Valerie Orr. We wish you a year filled with happiness, health, and love. You are truly a beacon of hope, love, and poise.
Happy birthday, First Lady.
Happy birthday, First Lady.
To Valerie Orr. Girl, you know, you mean the world to me and Colleen. You're so special to us, and we just love you to death, and we just want to say happy birthday, and we pray that you have many, 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 many more. And can y'all put me in A-flat? Put me in A-flat. No, don't worry about it. Okay. Love you, girl.
All right, today is a big day for you, First Lady Valerie Orr. It is a blessing indeed, and we just want to come in our little special way to say happy birthday to you. So I found these wonderful boys and girls, and they're going to give you their version of happy birthday.
My name is Peyton, and I want to wish you the best birthday.
My name is Shia, and I want to wish you a good birthday and have fun.
Hi, my name is Addison, and I hope you have the best birthday.
Hi, my name is Joy, and I want to wish you a very happy birthday in your own special way.
My name is Devin, and I want to wish you a very, very happy birthday.
Well, of course, they call me Mr. Richardson, but it's Anthony Q. Richardson, and I want to wish you a lovely, most blessed birthday, First Lady Valerie Orr. On the count of three, can we give a big shout out? One, two, three.
Happy birthday! Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, First Lady Orr.
Lady Orr from the Hurt family.
Happy birthday, Lady Orr. We want to wish you a happy birthday. The truth is, your presence is really a gift to us, but we still want to say happy, happy birthday.
Yes, happy birthday, Lady Orr. Thank you for being the most glorious woman you are. So thank you again and happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Sister Orr, on behalf of the Robinson family. We pray that you have many, many more. I know Pastor Orr will do a tremendous job in celebrating your birthday.
Oh. Come on, we can do better than that. Good morning, Brown. Amen. This is the day that the Lord has made. Anybody happy to be in the house of the Lord one more time this morning? Amen. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be so glad in it. A very special welcome to everybody that's worshiping with us today as we continue to change lives and make a difference here in the city of Memphis in South Haven. Now, whether you're here in person or you're joining us virtually, we appreciate you choosing Brown Baptist today. Now, if you're a first-time guest, we don't want you to be a stranger this morning. If you're a first-time guest, go ahead and text BMBC guest to 27636. I'm going to say that again. If you're a first-time guest, please make sure you text BMBC guest to 27636. You never know what you might get. You might get a gift of appreciation for us just for worshiping with us on today. And we also ask that you invite some of your friends and family. If you're here in the worship service, go ahead and send that text out in a group chat, in your family group chat, on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, whatever social media you use, TikTok. Make sure that we're putting the word out that Brown Baptist Service is about to get started. Now, a quick spotlight on some of our amazing members doing some amazing things here in the community. Congratulations to Ann War and Wendy Powell on celebrating 15 years of marriage this weekend. Congratulations to you. All right, then we also want to give a congratulations out to Deacon Derek Sr. and Rosalind Perry on celebrating 25 years of marriage this weekend. Congratulations to you. Then we also want to give a congratulations to Mr. Keith and Mrs. Terrace Watson on celebrating 28 years of marriage this weekend. All the love coming this weekend. Congratulations again to you all. And then also another congratulations to Donald and Essie Farmer. Yes, are they here? Yes, yes, yes. Congratulations on celebrating 35 years of marriage this weekend. She was classmates with my mama, so shout out to BTW in the house. And then we also want to give a congratulations to Ernest and Loretta Franklin on celebrating 52 years of marriage this weekend. Wow, congratulations. Then congratulations to Jada Sessom, who will be graduating from the University of Memphis with her Bachelor's of Science in Nursing. Congratulations to Nurse Jada. We also want to give a congratulations to Jade Ferris Anderson. Now, she will be graduating with her Doctor of Pharmacy degree from Samford University next weekend. So congratulations to you, Jada. Then another congratulation goes out to Reverend Sergeant Marcus Mosby. Now, he's being an STIS Investigator of the Month for the Memphis Police Department. So congratulations to you, Reverend Marcus. Then speaking about the police department, congratulations to Evangelist Angela Franklin and then also Dr. Stephanie Cole here at Brown. She recently graduated from the Memphis Police Department Clergy Academy. So congratulations to them. Amen. And more congratulations to Lexi Roberts. She's an 8-year-old XL silver gymnast. Now listen to this, she was recently awarded 3 gold medals at the Tennessee State Compulsory Gymnastics Competition. Amen, so congratulations to you. Hopefully we got a future Olympian on our hands. So congratulations to you. Congratulations to everybody that's celebrating something on this weekend. Again, go ahead and click the share button on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. Let's continue to show the world and show everybody about the love of Jesus and spreading the gospel by not only doing tagging your family, but also tagging your friends. And as we go higher into this worship service, let's make some noise for our youth choir. It's Youth Sunday, so stand to your feet. Come on, Brown. Stand to your feet as we go higher into this worship service with the youth choir. Amen.
Good morning, Brown. Oh, come on, we can do better than that. Good morning, Brown. We are now in the sanctuary where everything that we need is right here in the room. Come on, let's clap those hands all over the room. All right, here we go. Let me hear you say, come on, come on.
Come on, come on.
In the house of the Lord.
In the house of the Lord.
This is a place of hope
where you can be restored.
And now that you're here, with one accord.
Everything
you sound real good. Let me hear you say that again. Oh, come on, come on. In the house of the Lord. This is a place of hope where you can be restored. And now that you're here with one accord,
everything
oh, there's hope in us. There's peace. And the joy of the Lord. You sound real good. There's power in the
square.
There's love.
Everything you need.
Come on, clap those hands all over the room if you believe that. Oh. All right, here we go. One more time. Let me hear you say that. Come on, come on.
come on.
Come on, come on.
Every nation and tribe.
Lay down your fear.
Lay down your pride.
Lay down your pride.
With one accord.
With one accord.
Come on, everybody, clap those hands all over the room if you believe that.
Oh, there's hope in
us.
There's peace.
And the joy of the Lord.
Anybody believe that, that there's power in the sanctuary?
Sanctuary.
There's love.
Sanctuary.
Everything you need.
Everything you need is here.
Say that one more time.
Everything you need is here.
Come on, let me hear you put those hands together. Come on, if you believe that right here, right now, this is the place where I can get my healing. I can get my salvation right in this room. Hey, see everything you need. All right, here we go. See
everything.
Come on, does anybody believe that right here in this room I can get it? Oh, say
everything you need.
It's right here in the room. All right, here we go. Let me hear you say it. Oh, say it's here right now.
Here right now.
Say it's here right now.
Here right now.
The joy of the Lord.
Here.
You got to hear you say it's here.
Here right now.
Said it's here right now.
Here right now.
Said it's here right now.
Here right now.
Come on in. Let me hear you say it's here.
Here right now.
Said it's here right now.
Here right now.
The joy of the Lord.
Here right now.
Said it's here right now.
Here right now.
If you believe it.
Here right now.
That it's here right now.
Here right now.
Said it's here right now.
From Psalms 23 in the NLT, and it reads, "The Lord is my shepherd. I have all that I need. He lets me rest in green meadows. He leads me beside peaceful streams. He renews my strength. He guides me along the right paths, bringing honor to his name. Even when I walk through the darkest valley, I will not be afraid. For you are close beside me. Your rod and your staff protect and comfort me. You prepare a feast for me in presence of my enemies. You honor me by anointing my head with oil. My cup overflows with blessings. Surely your goodness and your unfailing love will pursue me all the days of my life. And I will live in the house of the Lord forever." Repeat after me. Greater is He that is in me, that is in the world. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Amen. Good morning, Brown Baptist. As we go to the Lord in prayer, please text your prayer request to 27636. Let us pray. Bow your heads and close your eyes. God, I pray over the people in the sanctuary and the people that couldn't make it today. I pray that they are okay and that everybody gets home safely. In Jesus' name, amen.
Great job. Amen. Come on, can we give them another hand clap of praise for that devotion? Brown, it takes a lot of courage to come up here, so we got to make sure we're encouraging our young people. Amen. Thank you, Caden and Chrisleen, for that fervent devotion. Now we come to one of my favorite moments here at Brown, our baptism moment. And so our baptism scripture comes from Matthew chapter 3, verses 1 through 6 in the New Living Translation. And verse 1 reads like this: In those days, John the Baptist came to the Judean wilderness and he began preaching. His message was, repent of your sins and turn to God, for the kingdom of heaven is near. The prophet Isaiah was speaking about John when he said, he is a voice shouting in the wilderness, prepare the way for the Lord's coming and clear the road for him. John's clothes were woven from coarse camel hair and he wore a leather belt around his waist. For food, he ate locusts and wild honey. People from Jerusalem, from all of Judea, and all over the Jordan Valley went out to see and hear John. And when they confessed their sins, he baptized them in the Jordan River. Brown, we already know that this is a very, very special morning for those that are getting baptized today. So as we see them coming out of that water, let's make sure that we're encouraging them, giving them all the applaud and all the love as we welcome them, not only to the family of Brown Baptist, but we're going to welcome them into the body of Christ this morning. Amen? Amen.
The water, take me to the water, take me to the water to be baptized.
Come on, clap those hands all over the room.
None but the right.
Stand before you today to participate in this ordinance we call water baptism. Water baptism does not save us, but what it does is it identifies us as being saved. The Bible tells us in Romans that when we confess with our mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in our hearts that he was raised from the dead, we shall be saved. And that is the first step. Salvation is the first step for all of our new converts. But there's another step that we have to be really intentional about, and we explain it to the new converts, and that is called discipleship. In other words, we could be saved, but yet not disciples. But it's disciples that's going to make the difference in this world in which we're living in. And so I want to encourage all of our parents, all of our friends and family who are here to support our candidates for baptism, to encourage them, motivate and inspire them to study the Word of God to show themselves approved. But more importantly, as family and friends and all, be an example, because action speaks a whole lot louder than words, and people are going to do more of what they see than what they individuals say. So just help us, support us, and to show your commitment when we bring these young these individuals up out of the water, give them a celebration of that they can really truly remember, not just for the sake of celebrating, but your commitment that you are going to be that example, you're going to be that model, so that we will actually know how to perform, how to act in the household of God. Amen. Amen. So we have many Black Baptist candidates for today, and that's something really, truly to celebrate. God is good to us. Amen.
Carter, how are you doing?
Good.
Carter, do you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he died on the cross for your sins?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he was buried and on the third day rose again with all power in his hands?
Yes, sir.
And Carter, have you asked Jesus to come into your heart and become the Lord, the Master, and the boss of your life?
Yes, sir.
Amen. Will Carter's family please stand? In obedience to the great head of the church, and upon the confession of your faith, I indeed baptize you, Carter, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Miles, how are you doing?
Good.
Miles, do you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he died on the cross for your sins?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he was buried and on the third day rose again with all power in his hands?
Yes, sir.
And Miles, have you asked Jesus to forgive you of your sins?
Yes, sir.
And are you ready to make him the Lord, the Master, and the Ruler, the boss of your life from this day forward?
Yes, sir.
Amen. Will Miles' family please stand? In obedience to the great head of the church, and upon the confession of your faith, I indeed baptize you, Miles, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Benny, how are you doing?
Doing fine.
Benny, do you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God?
Yes.
Do you believe that he died on the cross for your sins?
Yes.
Do you believe that he was buried and on the third day rose again with all power in his hands?
Yes.
And Benny, have you asked Jesus to forgive you of your sins?
Yes.
And are you ready to make him the Lord, the Master, the Ruler of your life from this day forward?
Yes.
Amen. Well, Benny families, please stand. In obedience to the great head of the church, and upon the confession of your faith, I indeed baptize you, Benny, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. God bless you. Okay, I got you. Kendall, how are you doing? Kendall, do you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God? Do you believe that he died on the cross for your sins? Do you believe that he was buried and on the third day rose again with all power in his hands?
Yes, sir.
And Kendall, have you asked Jesus to forgive you of your sins?
Yes, sir.
And are you ready to make him the Lord, the Master, the Ruler, the boss of your life from this day forward?
Yes, sir.
Amen. Will Kendall's family please stand? In obedience to the great head of the church and upon the confession of your faith, I indeed baptize you, Kendall, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amber, how are you doing? Amber, do you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he died on the cross for your sins?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he was buried and on the third day rose again with all power in his hands?
Yes, sir.
And Amber, have you asked Jesus to forgive you of your sins?
Yes, sir.
And are you ready to make him the Lord, the Master, and the Ruler of your life from this day forward?
Yes, sir.
Amen. Will Amber's family please stand? In obedience to the great head of the church, and upon the confession of your faith, I indeed baptize you, Amber, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Lauren, how are you doing?
Good.
Lauren, do you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he died on the cross for your sins?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he was buried and on the third day rose again with all power in his hands?
Yes, sir.
And Lauren, have you asked Jesus to forgive you of your sins?
Yes, sir.
And are you ready to make him the Lord, the Master, the ruler of your life from this day forward?
Yes, sir.
Amen. Will Lauren's family please stand? In obedience to the great head of the church, and upon the confession of your faith, I indeed baptize you, Lauren, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Bryce, how are you doing?
Good.
Bryce, do you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he died on the cross for your sins?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he was buried and on the third day rose again with all power in his hands?
Yes, sir.
And Bryce, have you asked Jesus to forgive you of your sins?
Yes, sir.
And are you ready to make him the Lord, the Master, the ruler of your life from this day forward?
Yes, sir.
Amen. Will Bryce family please stand? In obedience to the great head of the church, and upon the confession of your faith, I indeed baptize you, Bryce, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Alicia, how are you doing? Alicia, do you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he died on the cross for your sins?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he was buried and on the third day rose again with all power in his hands?
Yes, sir.
And Alicia, have you asked Jesus to forgive you of your sins?
Yes, sir.
And are you ready to make him the Lord, the Master, and the ruler of your life from this day forward?
Yes, sir.
Amen. Will Alicia family please stand? In obedience to the great head of the church, and upon the confession of your faith, I indeed baptize you, Alicia, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Good job. Salia, how are you doing?
I'm good.
Salia, do you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he died on the cross for your sins?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he was buried and on the third day rose again with all power in his hands?
Yes, sir.
And Salia, have you asked Jesus to forgive you of your sins?
Yes, sir.
And are you ready to make him the Lord, the Master, and the ruler of your life from this day forward?
Yes, sir.
Amen. Will Salia's family please stand? In obedience to the great head of the church, and upon the confession of your faith, I indeed baptize you, Salia, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Tanisha, how are you doing?
I'm fine, sir.
Okay. Tanisha, do you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he died on the cross for your sins?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he was buried and on the third day rose again with all power in his hands?
Yes, sir.
Amen. Tanisha, have you asked Jesus to forgive you of your sins?
Yes, sir.
And are you ready to make him the Lord, the Master, the ruler of your life from this day forward?
Yes, sir.
Amen. Would Tanisha's family please stand? In obedience to the great head of the church, and upon the confession of your faith, I indeed baptize you, Tanisha, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Daphne, how are you doing?
I'm good.
Daphne, do you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he died on the cross for your sins?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he was buried and on the third day rose again with all power in his hands?
Yes, sir.
And Daphne, have you asked Jesus to forgive you of your sins?
Yes, sir.
And are you ready to make him the Lord, the Master, and the ruler of your life from this day forward?
Yes, sir.
Amen. Would Daphne's family please stand? In obedience to the great head of the church, and upon the confession of your faith, I indeed baptize you, Daphne, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Adrian and Harmony, how are you all doing?
Good.
Do you all believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he died on the cross for your sins?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he was buried and on the third day rose again with all power in his hands?
Yes, sir.
And have you all asked Jesus to forgive you of your sins?
Yes, sir.
And are you all ready to make him the Lord, the Master, the ruler, the boss of your life from this day forward?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Amen. Will Harmony and Adrian's family please stand? In obedience to the great head of the church, and upon the confession of your faith, you all's faith, we indeed baptize you, Harmony and Adrian, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Joseph and Zandia, do you all believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he died on the cross for you all sins? Do you believe that he was buried and on the third day rose again with all power in his hands? And have you all asked Jesus to forgive you of your sins? And are you all ready to make him the Lord, the Master, and the ruler of your life from this day forward? Amen. With Zandia and Joseph's family, please stand. In obedience to the great head of the church, and upon the confession of you all faith, we indeed baptize you, Zandia and Joseph, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Chance, how are you doing?
Good.
Chance, do you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he died on the cross for your sins?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he was buried and on the third day rose again with all power in his hands?
Yes, sir.
And Chance, have you asked Jesus to forgive you of your sins?
Yes, sir.
And are you ready to make him the Lord, the Master, and the ruler of your life from this day forward?
Yes, sir.
Amen. Would Chance family please stand? In obedience to the great head of the church, and upon the confession of your faith, we indeed baptize you, Chance, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Chance's two little sisters. Put your feet under the rod. Allison and Jada, how are you all doing?
Good.
Do you all believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he died on the cross for your sins?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he was buried and on the third day rose again with all power in his hands?
Yes, sir.
And have you all asked Jesus to forgive you of your sins?
Yes, sir.
And are you ready to make him the Lord, the Master, the ruler of your life from this day forward?
Yes, sir.
Amen. Chanson. Allison and Jada's family, please stand. In obedience to the great head of the church, and upon the confession of you all faith, we indeed baptize you all, Allison and Jada, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. We say the best for last. Today is Zuri's physical birthday today. And so we're not just celebrating her new birth, but we're celebrating her birthday as well. And I would like if we could just do just a little short version of, you know, to save Pastor Orr's voice and he don't have to call Zuri. Let's give her a birthday wish, a happy birthday, if we could do that. Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Amen. Amen. Zuri, how are you doing on this birthday?
Good.
Zuri, do you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God?
Yes.
Do you believe that he died on the cross for your sins?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that he was buried and on the third day rose again with all power in his hands?
Yes, sir.
And Zuri, have you asked Jesus to forgive you of your sins?
Yes, sir.
And are you ready to make him the Lord, the Master, and the ruler of your life from this day forward?
Yes, sir.
Amen. Would Zuri's family please stand? In obedience to the great head of the church, and upon the confession of your faith, we indeed baptize you, Zuri, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you. Lord, it's an honor. I know the angels in heaven are rejoicing over one soul. Oh my goodness, how much rejoicing is happening in the kingdom of heaven. And it's also happening in this local body, dear Lord, because you are entrusting a lot of souls to this body. And you are giving us a grave responsibility to make disciples of everyone that have actually been baptized. So help us, lead us, guide us, dear Lord, that we will be the models that you have called and purposed for us to be, so that we can actually instruct, that we can lead, that we can be those examples of how a child should act in the household of God. Lord, bless us in a mighty way. And may these candidates, dear Lord, study your word to show themselves approved. May they say yes to what is right, no to what is wrong through the power of your Holy Spirit, dear Lord, and leave the consequences to you. Lord, we give you all of the honor, the glory, and the praise. And we look forward to that day when we see you face to face in the kingdom of heaven. And all of us say, hear you say, well done, thy good and faithful servants. We love you. We adore you. Bless this worship service today. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Good morning. Good morning.
It is a pleasure indeed to be here. A pleasure indeed. I brought these beautiful boys and girls with me. Let's give them a big round of applause. Thank the Lord for them. Amen. I want to be in the children's choir. I'm going to join in here for a moment. We have little Miss Zoe Albright on the front and have our band. We're going to just give honor to Jesus. Yes. Let us just think of Jesus for just a moment.
Good morning, Brown Baptist. Let us worship and praise the worthy one. He gave his life for us so that we may have it more abundantly. And do you know who I'm talking about? I'm talking about Jesus. He's the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, and the Prince of Peace. He's my Master, my Savior, and my everything. Worship the worthy one with us. Hallelujah.
Giving all honor to Jesus.
Giving all honor.
Giving all honor.
Giving all honor to Jesus. Giving all honor to Jesus. Giving all honor to Jesus. Giving all honor to Jesus.
Let's give them all honor.
Yeah.
Give me all honor. Here we go. Can we all sing that church? Giving all.
Giving all.
That's it.
Giving all honor to Jesus. Giving all honor to Jesus.
Giving all honor.
Giving all honor to Him.
Somebody make some noise in the house.
Brown Baptist family, this is the day the Lord has made, and we all have a reason to rejoice and be glad in it. We're so happy that you made the decision to worship with us today as we continue to change lives and make a difference. Our prayer is that you experience the love of Christ and God's miraculous power in today's worship experience. To our guests, we would love to connect with you, so please text BMBC guest to 27636 to let us know a little more about you and to receive a gift of appreciation. Help us show the world God's love through all of our digital platforms. Make sure you like, love, tag your friends, and comment on the live stream and invite others to worship with you. Here are your announcements for this week.
We are excited to celebrate and honor Mrs. Valerie B. Orr this weekend for her birthday. Join us immediately after worship in the gym. Ladies, prepare to join us for the women's kickoff with special guests Gwenzetta Pollard on Saturday, May 4th at 10 a.m. at our main campus, 980 State Line Road. Please register for the free event by scanning the QR code or at brownbaptist.org. Attention, all BMBC volunteers, you are invited to the Brown Family Reunion Volunteer Appreciation. It's a soulful mystery theater on Saturday, May 4th, 12:30 p.m. at our main campus gym, 980 State Line Road East. We want to celebrate you. Wear your favorite BMBC shirt and get ready for the Soulful Mystery Theater Volunteer Appreciation Brunch. The church seems to be the target of thieves and others with the intent to bring harm. Let's prepare to protect the flock. Safeguard Consultants and Brown Baptist Emergency Response Team presents the Protecting the Flock Church Safety and Security Seminar on Friday, May 17th and Saturday, May 18th at our South Campus, 7200 Sweeney Road in South Haven. The cost is only $69.99 per person or $49.99 for groups of four or more and does include a meal. Register by scanning the QR code at brownbaptist.org or text security to 27636. New BMBC members, you're invited to join us at the Spring Connect Group, connecting your relationships with Christ and the church. Sundays at 9:45 a.m. at our South Campus, 7200 Sweeney Road. Come study the Word of God and connect with other new members. Get ready to start the party at Vacation Bible School, June 3rd through 6th. Adult daytime classes at our main campus fellowship hall, 980 State Line Road East, and Vacation Bible School for all ages at our South Campus, 7200 Sweeney Road. For more information, email bbs@brownbaptist.org. Mark your calendars and prepare to join us for a denim and white 55th birthday celebration honoring our beloved pastor, Bartholomew Orr, on Sunday, June 23rd. Seating is limited and this will sell out. It's the Denim and White Birthday Bash at Guest House at Graceland, June 23rd at 5:55 p.m. Get your tickets today by visiting brownbaptist.org.
Those are your announcements for this week. To get all the updates, information, and details, text BMBC to 27636. Visit our website, brownbaptist.org and follow us on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and X. And remember, BMBC family, it is the year of health, a year dedicated to spiritual, physical, and emotional rejuvenation. Join us on a journey of less is best as we focus on activities and initiatives that nurture our body, mind, and soul. Let's get ready to change lives and make a difference as we create a space where we can connect to Christ, grow together, serve others, and go everywhere to share the gospel. Have a blessed and incredible week.
Amen. God bless you. Thank you so very much, Monica. Look, let's govern ourselves according to all of those announcements. And having our children and babies been done such a wonderful job today. To God be the glory. Thank God for them leading. Thank you, Minister Kevin Smith, as well. And we're praying for all of those requests that have come in. You can continue to text those requests to 27636. But Brown, we want to continue to pray for just so much is going on in our land and country right now. And there are so many different requests from sickness. We want to keep them lifted up to the Lord, praying for your husband. Praying for your children and family. Requests coming in, just asking God for Sister Ernestine, amen, coming up for surgery. We're praying for you this morning, for Brittany, for praying for you this morning as well. For all of the students doing the state testing, praying for them, for our college students, many of them. This is their last week of exams, and so we're praying for them even now. And then we want to be praying for all of our bereaved families, y'all. Yesterday, funeralized Brother Edmund Lindsay, one of the longtime members here at Brown. We want to be praying for his wife, Mother Maddie Lindsay, and the entire family. Want to be praying also next week. We'll be funeralizing a couple of more of our members, faithful around here, Jackie Metcalf, as well as Edwina Quarles. Want to keep those family members in our prayers. Yesterday morning, baby Josiah, passed away, and want to be praying for his parents, Precious and Joseph, in a very special way, even as that entire Daniel family. And then just a little while ago, and I appreciate his grandson is here, Brother John Allen, but his grandfather, Pastor Benny Hopkins Sr., passed away this morning. Want to be praying for that entire family and for the Hopkins family there in South Mississippi as well. We know our God is a God of comfort and a God of strength. And for all of those that have been dealing with sickness of every kind, hospitalizations, we're lifting you up to the Lord even now. Well, we have come to a ministry of love where we express our appreciation to God through the giving of our tithes and our offerings unto Him. It is indeed more blessed to give than to receive. God is using this ministry in tremendous ways. Did y'all see how many have come into the body of Christ? To God be the glory. For every soul that have been baptized today, thank you, Pastor Jackson. And even this past week, Principal Mosby sent me some pictures this past week of her students there at Oak Haven. They were actually in the room reading the Bible. That morning, the Gideons had been there, handed out Bibles. And who says that the Word of God is out of school? No, the Word of God is in school. Amen. And Brown, it is because of partnerships and your faithfulness with partnerships like the Gideons and others that we're able to see lives change and souls saved, all for the glory of God. So as we honor God today with the first fruits of our increase, we're thankful for you joining in with us. Exodus reminds us that none should appear before God empty-handed. Every worship ought to give something unto the Lord. And as we honor Him, there are many ways that you can give here at Brown. If you need to offer an envelope, our ushers are in the aisle. Thank God for these junior ushers. Amen. Give the young people another hand. Amen. Train them up in the way that they should go, that when they are old, they would not depart from it. You can also give, those that are watching online, you can give right there online at brownbaptist.org/give. You can give using Cash App, $BrownBaptist. You can also call your gift in to 662-342-6407, or you can also use our app and give through the BMBC app. But whatever way you give today, thank you for being a partner in ministry and a friend of what God is doing here at Brown. Malachi chapter 3 verse 10. Come on, let's read that together. Bring all the tithes into the storehouse so there will be enough food in my temple. If you do, saith the Lord of heaven's army, I will open the windows of heaven for you. I will pour out a blessing so great you won't have enough room to make it in. Try it. Put me to the test. And Father God, we're so thankful right now that we're able to give, God, that we're able to plant a seed to give back to you our tithe, that tenth of what you blessed us with, that we're able to go above and beyond and to continue to give to missions and vision. And Lord, we are thankful for the generosity of your people. As we honor you right now, God, touch, bless, restore. Lord, I pray for financial breakthroughs, for increase. God, I pray that you would rebuke the hand of the devourer for our sake, that you would take even the little and stretch it, God, that it would meet all of the needs that these your people have. We love you and we thank you. And you know the needs of this ministry. Give us more than enough to do everything that you have called us to do. And God, we'll forever give thy name the praise. The victory is already yours. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our ushers are coming at this time to partake of our tithes and our offering. And as we give, our young people will continue to lead us in this time of worship. Amen.
Somebody is a witness today that he'll turn it around. Somebody was at your lowest, but God turned it around. He gave you joy in the midst of your sadness, restored your hope. He turned it around. Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Won't he bring you out of some dead situation? To God be the glory. To God be the glory. Yeah. Bless his name. The years that the locusts have eaten up, time you thought you would get back, but God said, I'm going to give you everything back that the enemy stole from you. And he did it. I don't know about y'all, but God has been too good to us, kept us too well. Some of the young folks told me this morning that they had some of their friends that was in Orange Mound yesterday. Even when the shooting was going on, y'all, that could have been some of our folks. But God, but God, but God, bless his name. Yeah. Thank you, Jesus, for turning it around. Come on, give him glory, give him glory. Come on, D-Reed, yeah, yeah. He's worthy of all the praise.
Been so good to us. Thank you for your protection, for your hand of mercy. So much is happening all around us, God, and yet you've allowed the golden moments of our lives to roll on one more time. And for that, we just say thank you right now. We thank you for another privilege of worship. God, we ask in the name of Jesus, speak to our hearts, speak through us, that your word may go forth, that our coming will not be in vain. God, where we're weak, build us up. Where we are torn down, make us strong. Touch right now. Lord, I pray for receptive hearts and minds, that you will get our attention, God, and that today would be a life-changing experience for every last one of us, for those that are watching, those that are in person. May your Holy Spirit just move on the altars of our heart. We'll be careful to give thy name the praise. The victory is already yours. Thank you again, God, for every request that have come in, God. May your grace meet every need. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 Thank God again for these young people. And truly we give praises to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Honor to Pastor Anderson, to all of these pastors and ministers, these officers, amen, to these mothers, to ushers, to each of you. It's good to be in the house of the Lord one more time. And we are so thankful. Thank God again for all of those who have been leading, Minister Kevin Smith, Pastor Jackson. Thank you so very much. Amen. It's been good just to be able to sit back. Amen. And to take it all in. And thank you, Brown, for your prayers as well this week. Continue to pray for us and pray for just total restoration. Amen. But we are thankful. Y'all know our pattern. We are reading the Bible. We're reading a chapter a day. Matter of fact, I was preaching a funeral yesterday, and I preached right from our devotional reading. And so if you're not already signed up, matter of fact, if you don't already have one, they got it two different ways. For those of us who are over 50, amen, you need the larger print. They got the larger print for you. And then if you need the smaller one, but pick one of these up on your way out. Post it at your job. Put it up. Look, put it up in the break room so that others can read along with you. You never know. God may lead you to start a Bible study right there at your job. That can be your ministry. Amen. And whatever we read on Wednesday becomes what we study for Bible study. What we read on Friday becomes what we study, preach for the weekend. So Proverbs chapter 6. And I want to call your attention to verses 20 through 23. Proverbs chapter 6, verse 20 through 23. Proverbs chapter 6, verse 20 through 23. And when you should have found that, come on and say amen. Proverbs chapter 6, beginning with verse 20, these words are recorded therein. My son, obey your father's commands and don't neglect your mother's instruction. Keep their words always in your heart. Tie them around your neck. When you walk, their counsel will lead you. When you sleep, they will protect you. When you wake up, they will advise you. For their command is a lamp and their instruction a light. Their corrective discipline is the way of life. I want to preach to your hearts this morning from this subject. Follow the rules or else. Follow the rules or else. Is that a threat? Are you really trying to threaten us, preacher? What do you mean, follow the rules or else? I mean, rules were made to be broken. Everybody breaks the rule. I know we say it often, by the book, and you ought to play by the rules. But we also say that you ought to be able to bend the rules. Surely there is an exception to every rule. You don't expect us to just follow the rules. And yet, brothers and sisters, I thank God for Trey. Thank God for Trey, because this past week he showed me the value of truly following the rules. I didn't hear about this story, but Trey pulled it up on social media and told me about Jonte Porter and his lifetime ban from the NBA for simply breaking the rules. He didn't follow the rules, y'all, and started gambling. Not only was he gambling, but giving information to other individuals. I'd never heard of a Jonte Porter, didn't even know who he played for, wasn't aware of the fact that he had even been with the Grizzly. And then I started doing some Googling, and guess what I discovered? Even Stephen Smith, the bishop of ESPN himself, was in agreement of this lifetime ban. Now, some would say that's too long. Some would say it's too harsh of a system. Some would say that it really doesn't measure up, because here it is. He has forfeited a career making millions of dollars, and he only made $21,000 from the illegal betting. And yet, y'all, he didn't follow the rules. And then he had to suffer the consequence. I need all of us to understand something this morning, Brown, that since we can only control our actions and not the reaction, just follow the rules and you'll be fine.
You want to avoid lifetime ban. You want to avoid consequences with some big consequences. Look, you can't control what other folks are going to do. You can't even control what's going to happen when you're taking action. But you can control yourself doing the right thing and following the rules. Don't you not know? I believe that's the problem that we are faced with today. Everybody want to do what they want to do. You've seen it. Matter of fact, some of y'all done said it. I'm grown. You can't tell me what to do. I do what I want to do. You can't run my life. Who do you think you are, preacher, trying to put your rules and values on me? Don't you know I put my pants on just like everybody else put their pants on? And y'all, yet God is saying, follow the rules. Follow the rules. You mean all the time follow the rule? You mean every day follow the rule? You mean completely follow the rule? You got to be crazy. Matter of fact, we even sing the song, it's your thing. Do what you want to do. I can't tell you who to sock. Wrong. Isley Brothers, you got it wrong. It's not your thing. It's not my thing. But can I tell you, let me remind you, it's his thing. It's his command, his rules, his law. It is what God have told us right here in the Word of God. Matter of fact, all week long, and we've encouraged you all to read it along with your young people, but all week long, we have been talking about the same thing, and that is we got to read his word and do what it says to do. In chapter 1, verse 33, listen and live. In chapter 2, verse 1, listen and treasure my command. Chapter 2, verse 1, he's going to say, hang on to them. In chapter 3, verse 21. In chapter 4, verse 21, don't lose sight of them. Chapter 5, verse 7, listen and never stray from them. And then chapter 6, verse 20, follow, obey your father's command. Don't neglect your mother's instruction. That's what I want to tell you. Follow the rules or else. What's the or else? Or else the consequences you get. The consequences you get, I call this the cost, y'all. Proverbs chapter 6, verse 15. But they will be destroyed suddenly, broken in an instant, beyond all hope of healing. Young and old, there are consequences when we don't follow the rules. Whether it's being destroyed suddenly, whether it's being broken in an instant, whether it's being beyond the hope of healing, there are consequences when you don't follow the rules. And in chapter 6, verses 1 through 11, he talked about depleted finances. Do you not know if you don't work hard, if you go out there and co-sign for folks that don't even mean you any good, I'm going to walk away from? He said, it'll mess with your money. Many of our money is funny simply because we haven't been following the rules. Not only will it mess with your money and depleted finances, another consequence is a divided family. In verses 16 through 19, six things that the Lord hates, seven things that he detests. Halt the eyes, lying tongue, hands to kill the innocent, heart that plots evil, feet that race to do wrong, a false witness who pours out lie. And there it is, a person who sows discourse in family. Some families are tore up from the flow up simply because we don't follow the rules. You got baby mama drama. In-law outlaw situation. Because folks are not following the rules. Divided family and then depleted finance. But another consequence, y'all, is disgraced fame. Do you not know, y'all, he says in verse 33, he will be wounded and disgraced. His shame will never be erased. There are some consequences to our actions. So what is God saying to us this morning, Bram? God is simply saying we got to conform without compromise. Y'all, when it comes to the word of God, he says we got to line up with the word of God. We have to comply without complaining. We have to obey without options. But what if? No buts. What if? No what if. What about this? No what about that. It doesn't matter the situation. It doesn't matter the circumstances. It doesn't matter who you are or who who I am, none of us are above the word of God. Follow the rules, or else the consequences you will get. Not only the consequences you get, thank you for the one amen I got on that point. Let me give you the second point. Follow the rules or the control you will lose. The control you will lose. I call this a catastrophe, y'all, because verse 27, look what it says there. Can a man scoop a flame into his lap and not have his clothes catch on fire? Do you not know that you can play with fire? You can play with fire. Some of y'all played with fire last night. You can play with fire. Matter of fact, you can even get burned and catch on fire. Just this past week, don't know why he did it, what was going on, but just this past week, a man literally set himself on fire. Yeah, you can play with fire. Catch on fire, but you can't control and put out your own fire. Ain't that something? You can get yourself into some situations that you have no control over. I'm trying to preach it with the little voice that I have. Look, I need you to know something. When you don't follow the rules, you will lose control. You can't control who it affects. I know sometimes we feel like that I'm okay to do my wrong because, by the way, preacher, I'm not hurting anybody else. It's just me. Matter of fact, I don't even do it out in the open. When I get ready to do my stuff, I go behind closed doors. I do it in secret. It's not hurting me. But let me tell you something. It doesn't matter what your sin is, whether it's sniffing the wrong stuff, hanging with the wrong people, laying down with the wrong folk, whether it's stealing or taking. You never know, and you can't control who it affects, because it will always affect more than just you. If you're gambling, you're taking money not only out of your pocket, you're taking money off the family table. It's affecting more than just you, and you can't control who it affects. But then you can't control what they will do. When you cross the line, you never know what the next person is going to respond. Matter of fact, Proverbs chapter 6, verse 34, talking about this man that sleeps with another man's wife. He says, for the woman's jealous husband will be furious, and he will show no mercy when he takes revenge. You can't control what they will do. Let me tell you one more thing, y'all. You can't control how it will turn out. I know everybody feel like, well, if I just do a little wrong, I'm just going to get a little bit of problem coming back to me, but I can handle, I can cross that bridge when I get there, I can deal with it. But don't you know you can't control how things turn out? But preacher, it was just one sniff. But preacher, it was just one hookup. It was just one night. You can't control how it will turn out. Proverbs chapter 6, verse 32 and 33. But the man who commits adultery is an utter fool. He destroys himself. He will be wounded and disgraced, and his shame will never be erased. The control you lose, you can't control how it will turn out. And so here's what God is saying to us this morning, Brown. Control what you can. Control what you can. You can't control the reaction, but you can control your action. Look, control your own actions and your attitude before it happens. Control the very words that come out of your mouth. Control the response that you have to somebody else. Control what you can control. You ain't got to put on the outfit. Amen, somebody. It might be an all-white party, but you ain't got to wear that white outfit. You can go get something a little bit bigger, one that might fit you a little bit better. Look, you can control what you can control. You ain't got to listen to that music. You ain't got to dance to that song. You don't have to show up when the text message is sent out.
Ain't it sad, y'all? Just last night, what do they call that thing? Hook up, meet up, was sent out. Young folks gathered at a certain place in Orange Mound just to see car doing donuts. And then shooting started. Look, you can't control certain things, but you can control whether or not you show up. Mama them used to tell us, you don't just go everywhere. You don't just hang with everybody. You don't just do what everybody is doing. You got to take control over your own actions. The consequences you get, the control you will lose. Follow the rules or else the complications you maintain. I call these the controversies because some things have some lingering consequences to them. He's going to talk about a man stepping out and getting with an immoral woman and hooking up. But you know what? The sin can be any sin. It can be gambling. It can be pornography. It can be any sin. It can be smoking. Some of y'all like y'all little funny cigarettes and y'all. It can be any sin. And yet the same thing is here, brothers and sisters, that when you cross the line, when you do what God have commanded us not to do, there are some shame that won't go away. Matter of fact, there are some scars that won't go away. Some of us right now, we got scars even on our bodies that are reminders of some foolish mistakes that we have made. You ain't even with Marquisha. You still got her name all written on you. Trying to cover it up with all kind of flowers coming out of it. Look, there are some stuff that remains. Matter of fact, he says even here, he says, look, when you walk on hot coals, verse 28, can you walk on hot coals and your feet not blister? There are some stuff that will still remain. There are some videos that although they have been deleted, they were downloaded before they weren't deleted, and they are still out there. When it comes to the complications, y'all, from doing wrong, complications can be long-lasting. It can be a lifetime ban. Proverbs chapter 6, verse 35 is going to say that this jealous husband will accept no compensation nor be satisfied with the payoff of any size. The complication can be long-lasting. Maybe it was just one drink, yet that one drink has turned into a lifetime of a disease that is debilitating. It can be a long-lasting complication. But then the complication can be far-reaching. It can be far-reaching. You thought it was just one moment in time, and yet it has turned out to be deeper than what you could imagine. You thought that, hey, this is just a woman, and I'm going to do it, and then we're going to forget about it and go our separate ways. You're a fool. You're a fool. Reason why you're a fool, because the Bible says you're a fool. Verse 26, a prostitute will bring you to poverty. I like the old King James said, by means of a whorish woman, a man is brought to a piece of bread. Matter of fact, sleeping with another man's wife will cost you your life. Let me read verse 32 again, because somebody got offended when I called you a fool. Verse 32, but the man who commits adultery is an, and he destroys himself. The complication can be far reaching. Oh, brothers and sisters, why lose everything? Why fall from the top of your game all the way to the bottom for simply not following the rules? But here's good news. The complications are not grace resistance. Even when others don't forgive, even when others remember, even when it seems as if the stain is yet there, I need you to know that good God Almighty, there is a verse 36
It ain't in the text, y'all. He ends with shame. He ends with there is no forgiveness. He ends with never being erased. But praise be to God, if you confess your sin, 1 John 1:9, he is faithful and just to forgive you of your sins and to cleanse you of all unrighteousness. Yes, there's some complication, but you can still have your relationship restored with God. Come here, David. David had a one-night hookup with Bathsheba. And yet from that one night stand, God said, I'm going to forgive you, but the sword will never depart from your family. Complications you will maintain. And yet, y'all, God is saying to us this morning, confess what's crooked. Confess what's crooked. Oh, brothers and sisters, God is saying that when we find ourselves that we have crossed the line, when we have messed up, the best thing that we can do, matter of fact, the only thing that we need to do is to come clean before God. Because let me tell you something, just keeping it down on the inside, trying to hide it and cover it up, thinking that it will never come out, y'all, I'm here to tell you, God is saying you can be sure that your sin will find you out. But if you confess your sin, if you get right with God, he is able to take even misery and turn it into a ministry. He can take your mistakes and use it as a testimony to let somebody else know that he is a habit breaker, that he is a mind regulator, he's a heart fixer, and he can restore even what the enemy has stolen from you. So praise be to God, praise be to God. We can follow the rules. And if we follow the rules, y'all, we don't have to worry about everything else. It'll be fine if you just follow the rules. Young people, if you just follow the rules, do what mama and daddy taught you to do. Take that book sense, put it into your head. Stick with the right crowd. Stop running with the wrong folk. Follow the rules and you'll be fine. Because when you follow the rule, it says that you will guide you. They will guide you if you obey your father's command, not neglect your mother's instruction. If you keep those words in your heart, tie them around your neck. When you walk, their counsel will lead you. Aren't you glad we serve a God that is able to guide us? The Holy Spirit will lead and guide us, tell us where to go, who to hang with, what to do. Sometimes he'll tell you even the streets to avoid, because when you follow the rules, he will guide you. But not only will he guide you, when you follow the rules, he'll guard you. He said when you sleep, they will protect you. When you wake up, they will advise you. Aren't you glad that he give his angels charge over us to guard and to keep us all night long? That even no weapon formed against us will be able to prosper. If you just follow the rules, he'll guard you. He'll guide you. But then he'll grow you. He'll make you get better. Yes, there are going to be times that we mess up. But the commandment is a lamp. Instruction is a light. And corrective discipline is the way of life. You'll get to the point where you thank God for correcting you. You'll thank God for getting your attention. You'll thank God for tapping you on the shoulders. You'll thank God for not letting the hookup go through. You'll thank God for bringing you back into the right way. Why? Because he's trying to grow you. He's trying to better you. Matter of fact, he'll get so good to you until you realize that every day with Jesus get sweeter than the day before. That's all I stop by to tell you. Follow the rules or else. Follow the rules or else. The sentence may be a life ban. Follow the rules or else. The disease may not quickly go away. Follow the rules or else. The sentence may be swift and stiff. The punishment may be debilitating. Follow the rules or else. It might land you in jail. It might land you on a death row. Follow the rules or else. You may lose your job. You may lose your family. You may lose your livelihood. Follow the rule or else. The enemy has come but to steal, kill, and destroy. But praise be to God. If you just follow the rules, follow the rules. Put your faith in Jesus. Follow the rules. Love the Lord your God with all of your heart, soul, and mind. Follow the rules. Let your light so shine.
that men will see your good works. Follow the rules. Don't go to the right. Don't go to the left. But stay in the will of God. Follow the rules by being careful who you hang out with. For the companion of fools shall be destroyed. But he that walketh with wise men shall be wise. If you follow the rules and put your hope in Jesus, the one who died that Friday, shedded his blood, went down in the grave, but early Sunday morning he got up with all power in his hands. If you follow the rules, he'll walk with you, he'll talk with you, he'll hold your hand. If you follow the rules, he'll build a fence all around you. If you follow the rules, he'll protect you. He'll take you higher. He'll keep you. If you follow the rules, yeah, yeah, follow the rules. Follow the rules. You'll be fine. But if you don't follow the rules, there are some consequences. If you don't follow the rules, there is some control that is taken away from you. If you don't follow the rules, there are some complications that will never go away. You mean to tell me one mistake? Yeah. One mistake can literally cost you everything. Follow the rules, follow the rules. Follow the rules. Follow the rules. I don't know who I'm talking to today who may be watching online. Somebody's been struggling. Somebody have thought that you can play around, you can straddle the fence. Somebody have thought, I'll never get caught, it'll never affect me, it'll never catch up with me. And yet the Lord is saying, if you don't, it will. It will. And you don't want the consequences of losing it all. Every head bow, every head bow, every eye closed. Those that are watching online, last night, text message went out. And because a simple text message went out, folks showed up, not even knowing what was going to take place. But they showed up, and many was shot on the scene. Many had to run for their life simply because wrong place, wrong time, with the wrong folks. Are you running with the wrong crowd? Young folks, are you listening to the wrong music? Are you indulging in the wrong activities? Are you watching the wrong stuff? Are you not following the rules? Are you thinking that I'm doing it at night in the dark behind the closed door, nobody will ever see it? And yet, brothers and sisters, sooner or later it catches up. Father God, in the name of Jesus, somebody is on the verge of losing everything. Lord, you've given us time and chance to get it right. We should have already lost our minds. Many should have already lost our lives. And yet, God, it was your grace and mercy that didn't allow the accident to take us out. Your grace and mercy that did not allow the bullet to land on this target. And so, Father God, in the name of Jesus right now, God, come into our hearts. Arrest our spirit. Sweet Holy Spirit,
Do a new work in each of our lives, young and old. Bring us back between the lines. Help us to follow the rules. Lord, somebody think that they are above the rules. They think that they're too big, they're too important. And yet, God, none of us are above your law. And so humble us right now in the name of Jesus. Lord, even as we extend the invitation, Lord, I pray that somebody will say yes to you, that somebody will come crying, what must I do to be saved? Will you touch hearts, God? Would you send a revival even now in Jesus' name? Amen. I need the oil. The door is open. The door is open. Somebody need to say yes today. Yeah. Every eye, tomorrow is not promised to any of us, but the day that you hear his voice, harden not your heart. If you're watching, you can come down the virtual aisle by texting JOIN to 27636. Me now, my Savior, I come to, I come to thee. Somebody need to recognize that I need the Lord today. I need the I need you to know that whatever you have done is not beyond the grace of Jesus. The blood that he shed on Calvary Hill can cleanse every sin, can forgive every wrong, it can heal every hurt. Why don't you say yes? Why don't you say yes? Oh, bless,
bless me now. My Savior, I come.
Pray, church, pray, church. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I come to thee.
Just one more time, one more time.
I need thee,
Is there another one? Is there another one?
Yeah.
One have joined online. One have joined online.
Every hour.
Somebody else ought to say yes.
Oh, I need thee.
Somebody else ought to say yes.
Oh, bless me now.
He can do it. He can do it.
My Savior. My Savior.
Yeah, yeah.
My Savior, oh, I come, oh, I come.
Tomorrow is not promised to any of us,
I come.
But the day that you hear his voice,
oh,
harden not your heart.
I come.
God brought you here today for such a time as this.
I come to thee.
He wants to turn it around for you.
Help me say yes.
He wants to do something new in your life.
Yes.
He wants to give you a new lease on life.
Yes.
Oh, yes. Yeah, yeah.
Can you help me say yes? Yes. Yes. Hey, yeah.
Somebody ought to walk with your loved one.
Please have
you ought to bring them this morning.
Your way.
Yeah, yeah.
Please have your way.
Oh,
and
have
I'll
your
just
way.
Say, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey.
I need somebody to know the devil is a lie. The devil is a lie.
Hallelujah.
And today, you ought to say no to the devil. And you ought to say yes to Jesus. Today, you ought to say, I'm coming out. I'm coming out. I'm getting it right. I'm turning over some leaves and I'm making some changes. Here's another one. Here's another one. Here's another one. Yeah. Preacher, I'm too embarrassed to get up. I'm too ashamed to walk down and out. What am I going to look like taking a front seat? Let me tell you, you're in good company. Because all of us have sinned. Every last one of us have come short of the glory of God. And if it wasn't for the grace of God, we too would be right there. But God, but God, but God.
He brought me out. He brought me out. He brought me out. Oh, he brought me out.
If the Lord has done anything in your life, do that one more time. He brought me out.
He brought me out. Did he bring you out? Did he bring you out? I know he brought me out. He brought me out. Hey, yeah. He brought me out.
Yeah!
Yeah! Oh! Oh, yeah. He brought me out.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
He brought me out. He brought me out. He brought me out. He brought me out. Do I got some witnesses up in here? Did he bring you out? Did he bring you out? Did he bring you out?
Yeah!
Yeah! Hey! 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 Hiya!
This is my kind of party. This is my kind of party. This is my kind of party. I once was lost. Now I'm found. I was blind, but now I see. Somebody else ought to say yes. Somebody else ought to say yes. bless your name. Thank you for these who have come, those who have joined online. Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus that as we follow your rules, may we experience your favor and your joy in the name of Jesus. Lord, thank you right now for your deliverance. Thank you for your healing. Lord, thank you for breaking some chains, loosen some shackles, and setting us free. And I pray, God, that we will walk in the newness of life, filled with your Holy Spirit. We love you. We thank you. Knit their hearts with our hearts. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. When I think about Jesus, what he's done for me, when I think about Jesus, how he set me free, I can, yeah. When I think about Jesus, what he's done for me, when I think about Jesus, how he set me free, I can, come on, Brown, let's celebrate. Thank God for these who have come. Yeah. Give them glory. Yeah, 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 yeah. The world won't let you dance by yourself. If the world won't let you dance by yourself, we ought not let somebody come to Christ and dance by themselves. I need a couple of more folk. Come on, come on. Can I get a couple more of my praises? Come on, John Wayne. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Yeah, 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 yeah. You don't know like I know. the glory. Bless his name. Oh, bless his name. There are still those joining online. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, God bless you, God bless you. Yeah. Thank God. Ain't nothing like a Holy Ghost party. And we give God the glory. We give God the glory. Amen. Now, this we'll end on this note. Amen. Yeah. Yeah. I'm thinking about all the times I didn't follow the rules and the stuff that should have happened, that could have happened. I'm thinking about every accident that I should have been involved in. I'm thinking about every time I should have lost everything. But God. But God. But God. Bless his name. Valerie, happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. And matter of fact, amen. Amen. Y'all come on stand. Amen. 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 Take y'all hands off the instruments. Amen. 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 Mm. To God be the glory. I know there was a video. I know there was a video. Yeah. To God
God be the glory for the things. Yeah.
Come on. Last time. Come on, Dre.
God be the glory. God bless you. As we leave down from here, I want us to, we're going to go on over to the gym and just have just a little cake and punch and some cupcakes. But we thank God for Valerie. Thank God for her life. We thank God. And we're ever indebted, amen, to the great sacrifices that she have made. And may God continue to give her favor right now. This is the year of health. Less is best. 3 John verse 2. 3 John verse 2. Come on, let's say that together. Dear friend, I hope all is well with you and that you are as healthy in body as you are strong in spirit. Father God, Lord, we love you right now. Oh God. Somebody needs you as never before. Somebody need to make some changes. Somebody need to come back between the lines. Somebody need to stop running with the wrong crowd. And Lord, we're thankful for your message, for your word that is alive and well, penetrating our hearts. Lord, somebody need to walk away from some practices and some habits, some addictions that's getting the best of them. And God, I pray in the name of Jesus that even as we leave down from this place, that you will allow this message to simmer in our hearts and minds, and that you will restore families, forgive people of sins, that you will heal hurting hearts. Lord, I pray that you will loose some shackles, God. Lord, Satan is going to be so busy this week. For those who have come, for those who have made some decisions, the enemy is going to try to draw them back with everything that he has. I pray that you will be a fence around them. Oh, have your way, God, and rebuke the hand of the enemy. Lord, we see the killing that is going on, the foolishness that is just filled our streets. God, rebuke it in the name of Jesus. Block every attack that Satan will bring against us, every weapon that is aimed at us. And God, I pray for just victory and favor right now. So may you bless and keep us. May you touch and be with us. Speak peace to our hearts and minds. Thank you for Linda Owens, God. Lord, speak peace and healing to her right now in the name of Jesus. And Lord, I pray that you will restore joy as only you can do. And may your favor rest upon us. May you bless and keep us. Make your face to smile upon us and be gracious unto us. May you lift up your countenance. Grant us your peace. Is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Y'all come on. Amen. You're going to give on your way out. Amen. But come on around. Amen.